So, hi everyone, welcome back to bankexamstudy.com, and this is the third and the last part of our current affairs questions. I told you I would make four parts, but as I couldn't make some videos in last 2 or 3 days, so I decided to finish it in part 3 only. And let's start with the question. The very first question is, when was the National Productivity Week in India was celebrated recently? Whether it is from February 10th to 16th, February 11th to 17th, February 13th to 19th, 12th to 18th, or none of the above. So you have to tell me, when did we celebrate or when did we observe the national, hi Vibin, good evening, and you have to tell me, when did we observe the National Productivity Week in India? You have 5 options here and you can mark your answer, you can comment your answer in the live chat section. So let me tell you, it was celebrated from February 12th to February 18th, National Productivity Week. Question number, sorry, it's 52, which asked, what percentage of quota is provided to Gujars under Rajasthan Backward Classes Amendment Bill? Recently, Rajasthan government has decided to provide quota to Gujar community, and what is the percentage of quota provided to them in government schemes and institutions? 51D, your answer is correct, Vibin. So now you have to answer question number 52. What is the percentage of quota provided to Gujar community in Rajasthan? I would really appreciate if everyone who is watching this video participate in answering the question. That would be very helpful for you to revise the current affairs of February 2019. And the question number 52, I would like to get an answer from you. It is a very easy question. Okay, so answer of 52 is B, and Vipin, again your answer is correct. Now moving to question number 53, credit link capital subsidy and technology upgradation scheme is associated with which of the following sectors or things? Mahila Sahakari Samitis, ITIs, weavers, agricultures, and MSMEs. Hi Neha, answer to question number 52 was 5%, and your answer is correct. Now kindly let me know that credit link capital subsidy and technology upgradation scheme, which was recently extended, and to which sector it is associated? ITIs, weavers, agriculture, MSMEs, or Mahila Sahakari Samitis? If you know the answer, you can comment. Okay, let me tell you, the scheme is related to MSMEs, and the explanation is here. The cabinet committee has recently approved the extension of this scheme, CLCS TUS, for micro, small and medium enterprises with a total outlay of 2900 crore rupees on 13th of February 2019. If you haven't read about this scheme, then please revise the scheme and read it. 53A. Okay, so your answer is correct, Vipin. Okay, hi Harendra Kumar, and your answer is also correct. Let's move to question number 54. In TERI, R stands for Neha K is telling me that the answer to 53 was MSMEs and it was correct. So let me know the answer of question number 54. In TERI, R stands for rejuvenation, recycle, research, resources, or none of the above. And Vipin is saying it's D, resources. Anybody else who wants to give it a chance? Can you please comment the full form of TERI, Vipin, if you know the correct full form? Okay. Nirali Oza recently joined us and she is also telling it's D, and it is actually D. Correct answer is D. And the Energy and Resource Institute is the full form of TERI. Okay, so everybody knew the answer to question number 54. Let's move to question number 55. International Hockey Federation has recently conferred many awards, and who was given the Player of the Year award at International Hockey Federation? Recently, International Hockey Federation awarded many players, and who won the Player of the Year award at the same event? You have to provide me the correct answer. So answer to question number 55, I'm expecting a quick response from all of you, and the answer to 55 is B. Arthur Van Doren. Moving to question number 56, World Radio Day is observed on. You have to provide me the answer really quickly. February 14th, 13th, 12th, 11th or 10th. Very easy question, along also very important. World Radio Day is observed on February 14th. Neha K answer. Okay, that's done already. 56B, Anil Reddy Mandal, it's saying 56B, February 13th. Anybody else? Okay, so the correct answer is February 13. Rowdy007, your answer is also correct. Now moving to question number 57, which asks you to name the portal launched by Niti Aayog for the online licensing of Ayurveda Siddha, Yunani and homeopathic drugs. So what is the name of the portal Niti Aayog has recently launched so that people can get license for their Ayurvedic, Siddha, Yunani or homeopathic medicines? E Oshadi, E Ved, Vedehi, E Vidushi and none of the above. 57A. And anybody else for question number 57? Okay. So it was very easy. The answer is A. E Oshadi is the portal to get online licensing for Ayurveda medicine, Siddha medicine, and Yunani medicines. Moving to question number 58, who among the following is our Union Minister for Social Justice and Empowerment in India? Satish Nayar, answer A is correct. So tell me, इंडिया का सोशल जस्टिस एंड एम्पावरमेंट मिनिस्टर कौन है इन इंडिया? हु इज द मिनिस्टर ऑफ सोशल जस्टिस एंड एम्पावरमेंट? मुख्तार अब्बास नकवी, डी वी सदानंद गौड़ा, नरेंद्र सिंह तोमर, थावर चंद गहलोत और नन ऑफ दी अबव? फिफ्टी एट डी। एनीबडी एल्स? फिफ्टी एंड यस, इट इज थावरचंद गहलोत। क्वेश्चन नंबर 58 आंसर इज डी। मूविंग टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 59, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज और आर ट्रू रिगार्डिंग प्रणाम बिल? वी ऑलरेडी नो समथिंग अबाउट प्रणाम बिल एंड यू हैव टू टेल मी द स्टेटमेंट्स विच आर करेक्ट और इनकरेक्ट। इट स्टैंड्स फॉर पेरेंट्स रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी एंड नॉर्म्स फॉर अकाउंटेबिलिटी एंड मॉनिटरिंग। इट बिलोंग्स टू अरुणाचल प्रदेश। द बिल इंक्लूड्स पेरेंट्स ऑफ द पर्सन हु इज एम्प्लॉयड इन द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉयमेंट एंड फिजिकली एबल्ड सिबलिंग हु आर नॉट अर्निंग। सो ऑल आर ट्रू, नन इज ट्रू, ऑल आर ट्रू एक्सेप्ट वन, ऑल आर ट्रू एक्सेप्ट थ्री, ओनली वन इज ट्रू। If you have studied about Pranam Bill, you must know what is it and to which state it belongs to and what are the norms under this bill. Anybody who wants to answer this question can just. It's 59 D, all are true except 3. I don't think so, your answer is correct. Think about it, Vipin, because the scheme wasn't launched in Arunachal Pradesh, so this is incorrect. The full form of Pranam is correct, but the bill includes parents and physically disabled siblings or the siblings who are dependent upon the earning member. It does not include the siblings who are physically abled. Physically handicapped, able means they are physically fit and they can work. Okay, so read it carefully before answering. So only one is true. Neha K, read the options carefully because it's saying all are true, but all are not true. Only this statement is true. So only one is true. The answer is E. Moving to question number 60. Who has been awarded the prestigious Global Future for Nature Award 2019 for her work on marine conservation? Very easy question. Marine conservation ke upar kisko award mila hai Global Future for Nature Award 2019? Recently two other recipients the us award ke plus ek Indian thi. So unka name kya hai? Divya Girdhar, Divya Karnad, Divya Dutt, Divya Goswami or none of the above? And 60's answer is B. Very easy question as well as very important. Moving to question number 2061. Who won the Comeback of the Year award at the Laureus World Sports Award 2019? Kisko mila tha Comeback of the Year award? Tiger Woods, Novak Djokovic, Simon Biles, Naomi Osaka or none of the above? We have to do 90 questions. We have to finish 90 questions today. So answer quickly. And Sampath is saying it's B, and we've been saying it's A. And the correct answer is Tiger Woods, who is a golf player, and he won the Comeback of the Year award at the Laureus Sports World Award 2019. Sports current affairs are really important, so do read them carefully. No, it's not Novak Djokovic, Reshu Kumari. It is not Novak Djokovic, it's Tiger Woods. Correct answer is Tiger Woods, the golfer. Anjan Sahu's answer is correct, and Sonali Roy's answer is also correct. Hi Sonali, welcome to Bank Exams today. Okay, so moving to question number 62. Very important question because it is from the state events. Which municipal corporation of Chhattisgarh has won Swachhta Excellence Award 2019? Raigarh, Ambikapur, Durg, Bilaspur or Bhilai? Swachhta Excellence Award 2019 छत्तीसगढ़ की कौन सी म्युनिसिपल कॉरपोरेशन को मिला है? रायगढ़, अंबिकापुर, दुर्ग, बिलासपुर और भिलाई? It's a very easy question, so drop your comments quickly. Yes, it's Raigarh. Answer is Raigarh. Correct. Sampath knows the answer. Anjan Sahu, correct answer. Sonali Roy, Raigarh. And correct answer is Raigarh. Let's move to question number 63, a tricky one. Because I know you have studied the current affairs and you know who is appointed on which designation. So try to do it carefully. This is the name of appointed person, and this is the name of the designation along with the organization. So you have to match it. Govind Prasad Sharma, G.C. Anupama, Pramod Chandra Modi, and Umanath Singh. Here are the designations. Presidents of Astronomical Society of India, Chairman of Central Board Direct Taxes, National Book Trust, and First Lokayut of Nagaland. It's President of National Book Trust. So you have to match the appointed person with the designation and organization. Do it quickly. Sixty-three. He is saying D. Okay. Let's give other people some chance. We've been to answer the questions. They sure I didn't get A3 D4. Okay, A3. D4 and 63 is the correct D answer is the correct answer because Govind Prasad Sharma is the president of National Book Trust. G.C. Anupama became the first female president of National Astronomic Society of India. Pramod Chandra Modi, chairman of CBDT, and Justice Umanath Singh has been appointed the first Lokayut of Nagaland. So the correct answer, and you matched it very quickly, so you did study the current affairs. Very good. Moving to question number 64, read it very carefully. Which of the following statements is or are correct regarding Mukhyamantri Yuva Swabhiman Yojana? It was launched in Madhya Pradesh. It provides 100 days of employment every year to urban and rural youth. They would get 4,000 stipend per month. The scheme defines economically weaker sections as those whose families' annual income is less than 5 lakh rupees. So you have to answer the question very quickly. Vipin is saying the answer to 64 is D. Only 1 and 2 are correct. Anybody else? Okay, so here is the mistake. Let me tell you. The scheme was launched in Madhya Pradesh. This statement is correct. It provides 100 days of employment every year to rural youth only, not urban youth. So this statement is incorrect. The youth would get 4,000 of stipend. It is also correct. And the scheme defines economically weaker section to who are getting income less than or equal to 2 lakh rupees, not 5 lakh rupees. So only first and third are correct. This is not correct. This is not correct. Okay. So read the schemes very carefully. Moving to question number 65, which of the following statements is correct regarding Sujalam Suphalam Jal Sinchai Abhiyan? Very important scheme, but it is a state government scheme. It belongs to Tamil Nadu. Whether his statement is correct or not, the state government has increased its financial contribution to 70%, and the private groups getting involved in the scheme will have to contribute only 20%. So, which statement is correct? You have to answer. Anybody wants to answer this question or should I do it? Okay, so this scheme does not belong to Tamil Nadu, it belongs to Gujarat. The state government will contribute to 60%, and the private sector involved in the scheme will contribute to 40%. So, no statement is correct. So, B is the correct answer. Reshu Kumar, it's not C, it's B, because the scheme was launched in Gujarat, not Tamil Nadu. Let's move to 66 number of question. Sampath said it's D, which is also incorrect because the answer is B. Okay. So read it very carefully. Which of the following statements is or are correct for Mahatma Gandhi scholarship study in India? Sonali, your answer is correct. It's B. Okay, so 66, it is for Sri Lankan students. I'm sorry. The recipients of this scheme will get the cash received. They will get the financial assistance for 3 years of advanced studies, and the awardees will receive 1 lakh rupee annually. So, which statement is correct? You have to tell me. All are correct, whether none is correct, only one, only two, or only three. And Bhaskar Reddy says it's B. No statement is correct. But your answer is incorrect, Bhaskar. So read it very carefully. Shubham Jaitkar says it's 66. The answer is C. Only one is correct. And your answer is correct, Shubham, because the scheme is for Sri Lankan students, but it provides cash assistance for only 2 years of advanced studies. And this year, the government provided 30,000 rupees to each student annually, not 1 lakh rupee. So only one is correct. Yes, 150 students were selected this year and they belong to Sri Lanka and they got 30,000 rupees per year for their 2 years of study. Anjan Sahu, the C is the correct answer. Moving to question number 67, Reserve Bank of India created a single category for non-banking financial company corporations by bundling their present three-tier structure: asset finance companies, loan finance, loan companies, and investment companies have been merged into a new category called NBFC investment and credit companies, NBFC credit investment companies, NBFCs investment and credit control companies, NBFC investment and credit creation companies. So you have to tell me the correct answer to this question. Bhaskar, I'll get back to your query once I finish this video lesson. Hi Mohit, welcome to Bank Exams Today. You are a bit late for the session, but anyway, you can answer the questions right now. What is the answer to question number 67? Bhaskar, I have read your message, so don't worry. No need to delete it actually. NBFC companies क्यों कौन सी कैटेगरी में रखा गया है? टेल मी. इट इज NBFC इन्वेस्टमेंट एंड क्रेडिट कंपनी. सो द करेक्ट आंसर इज ए. एंड दिस क्वेश्चन इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इफ यू हैवेंट स्टडीड दिस थिंग, यू मस्ट स्टडी इट. ओह सॉरी. शुभम जैद के सेइंग कंफ्यूजन इज बिटवीन सी एंड डी, बट द आंसर इज ए. इन्वेस्टमेंट एंड क्रेडिट कंपनीज इज द करेक्ट आंसर. अंजन साहू, शुभम जैद का एंड रेशु कुमारी, योर आंसर इज करेक्ट. मूविंग टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 68, अगेन अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स आर करेक्ट रिगार्डिंग वीमेन्स लाइवलीहुड बॉन्ड्स? इट इज लॉन्च्ड बाय IMF, UN Women एंड स्मॉल इंडस्ट्रीज डेवलपमेंट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया, सिडबी. इट वॉज लॉन्च्ड विद एन इनिशियल कॉर्पस ऑफ 300 करोड़ रुपीज एंड इट प्रोवाइड्स लोन अप फ्रॉम रुपीज 1 लाख टू 3 लाख एट एन एनुअल इंटरेस्ट ऑफ 13 to 14% फॉर अ टेन्योर ऑफ 5 ईयर्स. यू हैव टू टेल मी वेमेन्स लाइवलीहुड बॉन्ड रिसेंटली इन न्यूज एंड विच स्टेटमेंट्स आर करेक्ट. शुभम If you have studied about women's livelihood bonds, it wasn't launched by IMF, it was launched by World Bank, UN Women, and SIDBI. It was launched with the initial corpus of 300 crore rupees, it is correct. But this statement is incorrect, but because the loan starts from rupees 50,000 to 3 lakh rupees. Okay, so only second statement is correct, other statements are incorrect. So D is your correct answer. And keep in mind, if you are preparing for RBI Grade B exam, these kind of questions are going to be in your exam, so be ready to face such situations there. Reshu Kumari says second is correct, and the second answer is correct, it's D. Moving to 69th question, Infosys. Ashish Verma is asking me for the schedule of LIC AAO exam. Okay, Ashish, I'll make the schedule and send it to you. Just drop your email ID or email to insia@bankexamstoday. Okay, so Infosys has recently launched an app for engineering students. What is the name of that app? Infase TQ, Infi TS, TS TQ, QT, or QS, or TR? Everybody knows the answer. It's TQ. Easy questions are on the way. Okay, question number 70. Which of the following statement is or are correct regarding world class initiative? Shubham Jayed ka 69B, correct answer. Answer question number 70. It was launched by Microsoft India. It focuses on women empowerment. It aims to train 5 million girls by 2030 through education and skill development. Reshu Kumari, Infi TQ, correct answer. Quickly answer question number 70. So this statement is incorrect, this is correct, and this is also incorrect because it was launched by Deloitte. It aims to support 10 million p girls, not 50 million, it's 10 million. 70's answer is C. All are correct except one. No, it's two. D is the correct answer. So moving to the next question, 71. Mohammad Tahir Ayala has been appointed the Prime Minister of which of the following countries? Oman, Serbia, Sudan, Chad, or Ghana? Quickly answer the question number 71. So okay, Reshu Kumari, you can make mistakes while answering the questions, no big deal. Okay, so Mohammad Tahir Ayala has been appointed the Prime Minister of it's Sudan. 71 C, C is the correct answer. Moving to say question number 72. Who won the 2018 Player of the Year award by Asian Hockey Federation? Asian Hockey Federation's Player of the Year award was given to Harmanpreet Singh, Manpreet Singh, Rupinder Singh, Sandeep Singh, or Ramandeep Singh. He's the hockey player as well, but not this Ramandeep, sir. Okay, so the correct answer to question number 72 is Harmanpreet Singh. And Vibin gave the correct answer. Why your name is not Vipin? It's Vibin. It's hard to pronounce it like this. Okay. Rajiv Gandhi International Cricket Stadium is located in Dehradun, Mumbai, Pune, Mizoram, or Mohali? Tell me where is Rajiv Gandhi International Cricket Stadium located? Dehradun, Mumbai, Pune, Mizoram, or Mohali? Reshu Kumar is saying, I think it is Manpreet Singh B, and question number 72 is not Manpreet Singh, it's Harpreet Singh. 73's correct answer is Dehradun. Rajiv Gandhi International Cricket Stadium is located in Dehradun. So, Shiva Ramakrishna Sampath, your answers are incorrect. Okay, 74th question. I'm going to end this session at question number 75. Which country's cricket team scored 278 for the loss of 3 wickets in 20 years and registered the highest ever total in T20s? Zimbabwe, Australia, India, Afghanistan, or New Zealand? The highest ever T20 score was recorded by Zimbabwe, Australia, India, Afghanistan, or New Zealand. To answer the question really quickly, we have to end the session. And 74th answer is Afghanistan. It's not New Zealand ratio, it's Afghanistan. Sambat, your answer is again incorrect. So study the current affairs very quickly and thoroughly as well. Okay. So recently, Tita Valla Museum has been inaugurated in which of the following states? Rajasthan, Uttarakhand, New Delhi, Odisha, or Madhya Pradesh? Where was Tita Valla Museum inaugurated, which is associated with Bagru hand block printing? So question number 75, let me know the answer. Rajasthan, Uttarakhand, Delhi, or Madhya Pradesh. Google account, whatever your name is, Rajasthan is the correct answer. Okay, let's finish the next 10 to 15 questions, whatever we have. Union Minister Railway, Minister of Railway Piyush Goyal has recently launched a dashboard that have all kind of information of Indian Railways to promote the transparency and accountability. So name the dashboard: Rail Divyam, Rail Raj, Rail Sugam, Drishyam, or Drishti. Very easy, because whenever you open the IRCT website, there is a chatbot on the side of the website. What is the name of that particular box? It is written on that box if you open the website, and it is Rail Drishti. Drishti is the name. So whenever you open the website, you will see "How may I help you" and Drishti. Question number 77. Who has been chosen for Meta Lifetime Achievement Award 2019? Ramanand Baghmare, Jignesh Patel, Sumit Shahi, Mahesh Elangchuwar, or none? Very quickly answer question number 77. And answer to question number 77 is D. 78. It is a scheme launched by Minister of Human Resource Development Prakash Javedkar. We have discussed this scheme earlier in the previous lessons, and this scheme is for the providing industry apprenticeship opportunities for the general graduate students who have been recently graduating during April 2019. And which of the following scheme is that? The name of the scheme is Sahayak, Sajal, Swayat, Shreyas, or none of the above. And the name of the scheme is Shreyas. We have studied some questions about shares, and the scheme is in news these days. So please make sure you study the scheme very thoroughly. And you have to tell me which of the following ministries is not participating in Shreyas scheme: Ministry of Human Resource and Development, Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, Ministry of Labour and Employment, Ministry of Minority Affairs. Which of the following ministry is not a part of the implementation of this scheme? There are 4 ministries, and which ministry is not included? And the correct answer is the Ministry of Minority Affairs is not included because each of these ministries have one scheme that is included in Shreya scheme, but Ministry of Minority Affairs is not a part of this Shreya scheme, and it should be ministry. Ashish, I got your mail and thank you for this. I'll make a schedule and send it to you. Question number 80. Who has been appointed the PNB MetLife's brand ambassador? Saina Nehwal, Marie Kom, PV Sandhu, Mirabai Chano, or none of the above? Okay, so the answer to question number 80 is PV Sindhu, who has been appointed the brand ambassador of MetLife, PNB MetLife's. Okay, so I'm ending this session at question number 80. There are 90 questions or 95 questions in your PDF that you can go, that you can get from. Let me tell you, where is this PDF? Okay, so when you go to bank exams today's website, you will get the current affairs question bank. You can download the PDF here, and this is the PDF that you can get free of cost. So there are all the questions that I have taught you, we have discussed in the videos, and some extra questions. You can get this PDF from the website. Also, we have recently launched the edition of RBI Grade B GK Digest March 2019. It is a paid version, so you can buy it from the website or from the mobile application itself. And now somebody asked me how to prepare for the, and Sonali Roy, this RBI Grade B GK Digest will be available in your courses, so you don't need to worry. And how to prepare for static GK, somebody asked. So I'm going to make the static GK section free of cost in the mobile application. You can study it from there only. And Ashish Kumar, I got your mail right now, and you will get the schedule as soon as I make it. And any question if you have, you can just drop it in the comment section. So most of the answers given by the students was correct, and I hope you keep on studying like this and you keep on working hard so that you can get to crack whatever your target is. Okay, so I'm ending this session here. Take care, keep working hard, and have a very nice evening. So the weather is very good here. I'm going to enjoy the weather, and you can study or whatever you want to do. So, okay, bye, take care, and have a very nice evening.